You're watching Bloomberg West, where we focus on innovation, technology, and the future of business. I'm Corey Johnson. Well, President Obama is promising aggressive action to introduce immigration reform, but Republicans are not in favor of that idea. House Speaker John Boehner just said, quote, the president will burn himself with immigration reform. Well, I sat down with Congressman Lamar Smith today. The Texas Republican has been an outspoken critic of the president. He also voted against increasing the number of H-1B visas.
I think it's disappointing that the president is threatening Congress and threatening the American people with these executive orders. According to the public opinion polls, three-quarters of the American people do not think the president should try to rewrite immigration laws by himself. He shouldn't go it alone. He should work with Congress, and then we can come up with a good product. But these kind of threats, if Congress doesn't do something, then I'm going to do something myself. The president himself has said he doesn't have the authority to do that. Several times in the last several years, he said he's told groups that he's met with, I can't issue these executive orders. It's contrary to the Constitution. It's contrary to my oath of office. I hope you'll go back and read what he said.
But now he's obviously saying he's going to push ahead. What are you going to do? Are you going to defund those programs? Are you going to keep those programs from going into effect even if he does enact things with executive order?
Yeah, if the president pushes ahead with these immigration executive orders and gives amnesty to millions of people and work permits to millions of people who are going to obviously compete with unemployed and underemployed Americans, there's going to be a price to be paid. We might try to defund what he does. We'll obviously try a lawsuit. There may be actions we can take otherwise. But this is when he does this, he's just going to poison, frankly, poison the barrel and make it awfully hard to work with him on other issues. Immigration, and so if he wants to accomplish anything lasting on immigration, then he's going to have to work with Congress and not just issue these executive orders.
All right, so there was a bill approved by the Senate that won't come for a vote because John Boehner won't let it come for a vote in the House. The current House, the president says the current House, he's got the votes there right now. Would you vote for that bill if it comes before you during this current Congress, during the session?
The Senate bill, the Senate amnesty bill from the last early this Congress, actually cannot be sent to the House because it's unconstitutional. It's contrary to the Constitution for the Senate to include revenue increasing measures in their legislation. So the reason that the Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid hasn't sent it to the House is he knows that we can't take it up. We're opposed to that bill because it is massive amnesty and it never really secures the border. It says after 5 years, if the border is not secure, then there'll be a study made. Well, we can't have that kind of, you know, putting off the secure borders, meanwhile giving amnesty to millions of people, which is just going to encourage more people to come into the country illegally. We need to start over, secure the border first. I mean, even under this administration, the government accounting office has said that only 15% of the border is under full control. That's why we have hundreds of thousands of people coming across the border illegally every year right now under this administration. So secure the border first, then we can talk about these other measures.
Would granting amnesty hurt the American workforce?
If the president grants amnesty by himself, rewrites the laws by himself, which I believe and he knows is unconstitutional and contrary to his oath of office, that is absolutely going to hurt unemployed Americans and underemployed Americans. Almost every study done, when you have that many more people getting work permits, it's going to have two harmful impacts on American workers. It's going to depress their wages and it's going to cost them jobs. And that's irrefutable, and I'm surprised and disappointed the president isn't going to put the American worker first.
I ran across a question, and I don't know the context, I'll read it briefly. It's about the DREAM Act, which allows children who have graduated from U.S. high schools who were born overseas, or people who served in the military to get some sort of conditional citizenship, those who are, in fact, good moral citizens. Yeah. You called it a nightmare for the American people. Is that an accurate quote? And what do you mean by that?
Well, the so-called DREAM Act, to me, is a nightmare for a couple of reasons. First of all, it basically gives amnesty to anyone in the country who's under 30 years old who claim they came in when they were younger. And the administration, when we quizzed them before the Judiciary Committee, said, yes, there's really no way for them to double-check to try to avoid the fraudulent documents that everybody would use. So it's an open invitation to massive fraud. It's an open invitation to about half the people in the country to say they came in when they were were younger and get amnesty. Plus, everybody in this category is also getting work permits, and then they'll be competing with American workers or driving down their wages. So this kind of a piece of legislation should not be done alone, should not be done in isolation, and we shouldn't be doing any kind of bill like this. It's just going to encourage more people to come into the country illegally.
That was Congressman Lamar Smith.